సంసార సాగరే మగ్నం దీనం మాం కరుణానిధే కర్మమోహ గృహీతంగం మాముద్ధర భవార్ణవాత్ శ్రీమత్ భాగవతాఖ్యోయం ప్రత్యక్ష కృష్ణయేవహి స్వీకృతోసి మయానాథ ముక్త్యర్థం భవసాగరే మనోరథో మదీయోయం సఫల సర్వథాత్వయా నిర్విఘ్నేనైవ కర్తవ్యో దాసోహం తవ కేశవా శుకరూపా ప్రబోధజ్ఞా సర్వశాస్త్ర విశారదా ఏతత్కథా ప్రకాశేన మదజ్ఞానం వినాశయా వందే నందవ్రజస్త్రీణాం పాదరేణుం అభీక్ష్ణశః యాసాం హరికథోద్గీతం పునాతి భువనత్రయం వందే నందవ్రజస్త్రీణాం పాదరేణుం అభీక్ష్ణశః యాసాం హరికథోద్గీతం పునాతి భువనత్రయం. There are two types of gurus. One is the guru who gives you the Diksha mantra. He is the Diksha guru. It can be Narayana, it can be Om Namah Shivaya, it can be Devi's mantra, Ganapati's mantra, it can be Subramanya's mantra, anything. Any mantra is given through a Diksha guru. There's a Shiksha guru. You can learn from everyone. Everybody is a teacher for you, negatively or positively. You can learn. I learn from 24 gurus. Please cooperate with me. Quickly, we'll pass through this line, the lines that tell us this 24 guru. The first is Mother Earth, that is Prithvi. Mother Earth is so patient. You can hit her, you can plow her, you can leave her parched, you can drench her, you can do anything to her, burn her. She remains patient. That's why you say, oh, she's patient like Bhumadev. That is what you say. We have to be patient. But today, none of us is patient. Getting two children ready for school, the housewife makes 20 calls and says, I have two children getting ready for school, as if she's doing social service. There was a time when our great grandmothers had 14 children, God bless them, and all of them brilliant. Please clap for them. They managed on their own. She has to cook for so many and she never bothered. She never made any fuss. And today, how much fuss we make? Getting ready for the office, getting ready for the school. How much fuss? Because we've lost patience. Forbearance is the first sign of faith. Abhishta sarvabhutanam maitra karuna evacha nirmamo nirahankara samadukha svakshami. Be like Mother Earth. The second lesson is from Vayu. There's a widespread disease called depression. I don't find people smiling at all. I don't know why. What the modern bestsellers say, it takes 64 muscles to make a frown and 2 muscles to make a smile, and still we exercise 64 muscles. Why can't you smile? You look better. You look better and you feel better. Vayu is telling us when the Vayu blows over jasmine, it has got a fragrance, but it blows over the garbage, it has a sting. Sukha, dukha, sukha, dukha, alternates. Sometimes you have a funeral at home, sometimes you have a grandchild at home. You have to accept everything. Did I not tell you the day before? Accept life. When you start accepting life, there won't be any depression. Please accept life. Sukha and dukha. Kabhi kushi, kabhi gham. You have to accept life. That is what the Vayu is telling us. This is a second lesson from Vayu. Man is the only intelligent animal who overeats. The Bhagavad Gita talks about moderation. There is one explanation for it in Ayurveda. The stomach is like a pot. Half of it should be filled with food. Are you listening? Quarter with water. The other quarter for air. If we eat till here, we will die. No animal overeats. No bird overeats. Man is the only one who takes the digestive pill, my dear listeners. Only one. You should know how to say no. Yukta ahara, yukta vihara, says the Bhagavata. It says, please stop. How do you stop? You may ask me, Amma, how do we know when to stop? If you eat three puris or three chapatis or three idlis, suddenly you get a burp. You get a burp. The burp is telling you, the stomach is telling you, stop eating. And you, in your wonderful, colossal ignorance, think that the food is digested and you can eat more. That is the problem. That is the problem. Stop eating. Eat the next day. It's not the last day in the world. This is what the Uddhava Gita is telling us in the Bhagavat Mahapurana. The third is the Akasha. The Akasha is blue. Always blue. Whether it rains, morning, afternoon, evening, night. Be your Satchitananda Rupa. You never change. That is what you have to be. Akasha. Up. Up is like the Ganges water. The Ganges water, when you touch it, purifies you. When you see it, purifies you. You talk about it, it purifies you. You have a sip of it. Bhagavad Gita, Kinchida Gita, Ganga, Jalalava, Kaneka, Pita. That is Mother Ganges. Mother Ganges purifies. We should also have so much punya. People see us, they should be purified. People talk about us, they should be purified. People touch us, they should be purified. In our scriptures, we have four punya shlokas. I can't forget my master Dikshitar telling us about it. Punya shloko nalo raja, punya shloko yudhishthira, punya shloka cha janaki, punya shloko janardana, hey guru vairappa, he would say, punya shloko nalo raja. Damayanti never calls him Nala. She says, Punya Shloka. Why did you abandon me in the middle of the night? Where are the marriage vows gone? Punya Shloka. Even when he committed a wrong, an atrocity, she's calling him Punya Shloka. The second, Punya Shloko, Nalo Raja, Punya Shloko, Yudhishthiraha. Yudhishthira is hit by a dice in the Virata Parva and his blood is dropping on the ground. Mother Draupadi runs and with the hem of her garment holds the blood from falling on the ground, and it's Virata asking her, what is your relationship with my entertainer? She says, shut up. One drop of his blood touches your country, for 12 years you will have famine. This is Punya Shloka. This is Punya Shloka. That is Yudhishthira. So full of Punya. So full of Punya. The third is, my Lord, Punya Shloko Janardanaha, Punya Shloka cha Janaki. Mother Sita is also Punya Shloka. The Ganges is pure and purifying. Agni is that into which everything falls and becomes pure. The Hindu needs Agni from start to finish. My Parsi brother worships Agni because it's the purest element. Whatever experience comes to you, digest it. Let it not leave a scar on your face. According to the Kamba Ramayana, I heard, Sri Rama is offered the kingdom. He smiles. And when Kaikeyi takes it back from him, he smiles sweeter. Clap for my Lord. Clap for my Lord. Only he can do that. Only he can do that. The Ramayana of Valmiki says, only you can be like this, Master. Only you can be like this. Next comes Chandra. Chandra is the one that waxes and wanes and waxes and wanes. But it is Chandra. Similarly, Harishchandra remained Harishchandra, whether he was sitting on the throne of Ayodhya or standing as the gatekeeper of the crematorium. You don't change. You don't change your basic principles. That is how we have to be in life. Next is Ravi. Ravi is the sun god. What does the sun god do? Whenever there is so much water, the sun god takes all the water. And when water evaporates, it becomes a cloud. When the world needs rain, the sun god gives us back in the form of rain. Water comes back to us. Similarly, a benevolent government, when there is increase in production, should have all the benefactions for him, for itself. And when the people are going through famine and crisis, give them tax benefit. That is what the government should do. The This is what Ravi is teaching us. Next comes Kapota. A pigeon has a female pigeon. Together they build a nest. They have small pigeons. That is how life goes on. Husband, wife, children. And then the father goes to bring some food for the little ones. So does the mother go. After a while, there comes a wild hunter and he casts his net. The little ones are caught in the net. They are helpless. The mother comes and sees the helpless children and she also falls into the net. The father comes and he also falls, wants to fall into the net. Somebody tells him, hold on, don't do that. You are there to remove people from the net and not fall into the net yourself. When we have companions who are going through moha and maya, it is our duty to bring them out of moha and maya. It is our duty. My master had a stock joke. Most children make a fuss about food. I call the dining table Kurukshetra. The moment we sit to eat, I don't like this. I don't want to eat. I'm eating out. I'm going out. I don't like this food. Food is something which is known as Anna Brahma. Anna is Brahma. Please don't waste. Please remember, you should not waste food. You should not disregard food, insult food. When crisis takes place, people are hungering for food. You know, when there is a calamity, how people wait for the packets to be thrown from the air. You go like beggars and ask for food. Once when there was a terrible catastrophe in Uttarakhand, at that time, I'm talking of Uttarkashi, there was an earthquake. Many of my millionaire friends from North India said, we were begging for roti from hut to hut. Then we understood what really the price of food is. They were offering 100 rupees for a roti. And the men in the hut said, don't be silly, we don't sell food. Can imagine how humiliating that experience must have been. Everything cannot be sold. Everything is not on sale. There is a thing called a human heart. There's a thing called feeling. And these people realized it then. My dear children, be like the python. The python takes whatever is coming to it. Big bird, small bird. Small animal, big animal. No food, yes. Everything it accepts. That is how. Sometimes there is no salt in the food. Don't shout at the cook. Maybe he or she got a bad message from home. Something is not, somebody is not well. Somebody is dying. Somebody has a financial crisis. He forgot to add salt. So what? Is it an international calamity that there is no salt in the food? Add some salt and have it. Don't shout at the cook. This is what the Ajagara is teaching. Next comes Sindhu. Have you ever thought of the sea asking for water? In the wanted column, wanted waters, no. No ocean, no sea asks for water. Why? Because the proverbial Gita tells you the sea becomes low and all the waters flow into it. Apuryamanam achala pratishtam samudramapa pravishanti yadvat tadvat kamayam pravishanti sarve sa shanti mapnoti na kama kami. If you run after desires, you will not have them. Stop. Stop and be still. Pray. And you will have your desires fulfilled. Next comes Patanga. There is a lamb and there is a moth around it. You've seen the moth going around the lamb? And it's burned, it's burned. You find the wings are getting burned and still it'll go around the lamp and get burned. Madhukrit is a bee. This is an advice for all listeners. Most of us go only to some speakers. Don't do that. Don't find fault with other speakers. You may have a favorite speaker, that doesn't matter. But please go and listen to everybody, just like the bee. It can go to the rose, it can go to the jasmine, it can go to the lotus, it can go to any champa flower, and yet, you know, the bee collects only honey, and the honey collected from all the flowers is the same honey, my dear listener, the same honey. Take the Parabrahma from everybody. Remember, no speaker becomes a preacher of the Lord by his willing. Preachers is not a job which you receive from naukri.com. The mantle falls on us and we become preachers. Please remember that. God's grace. Our guru's blessings. That is what makes you a preacher. Go and listen to everybody. Everybody has a sadhana. Everybody has his own guru's grace. Everybody has God's grace on him. So please go and listen to everyone, says the Bhagavata. Next, Gaja. This particular advice is mainly meant for sannyasins, those who are ascetic in their mind. what does the gajas do? How does the gaja get trapped? There is a cutout of a female elephant, and this gaja goes and touches the female elephant. Akhandanji Maharaj calls it the sparshasakti. There are so many asaktis. One of them is to touch the female elephant. Goes and sensuous delight. When he goes and touches the female elephant, he falls into the pit. That is how he is caught. Let us not be caught by sensuousness. Madhuha is one who collects honey. That is what Madhuha does. Oh, how much honey will I get from this place, this place, this place, this place, this place? And finally, when he goes to his garden, somebody else has taken away all the honey. Our partners ditch us. Our employees are fraudulent people. That is what happens. Over greed, excessive greed leads to devastation. That is what Madhuha is teaching us. Next comes Harina. How does the deer get caught? By that vulgar newt of the hunter, and it gets trapped. Have I not told you? A young man in Bangalore called me to bless his disco club. Imagine the cheek of the child saying, "Auntie, you come and bless my disco club." I said, "Krishna, what are you doing to me? Why are you trying me? Why should a person of my lifestyle go into a disco club?" I went into the disco club. I couldn't see anything. It was so dark, psychedelic effect. I said, "Hold my hand." I held his hand and I said, "What do you want? Please bless." And I really blessed. The next month, the disco club was closed. How can I allow such music when we have heard the bhajans of M.S. Subbulakshmi Amma, when we have heard the bhajans of Haridasji Maharaj? How, when you've known Tukaram and Namdev, when you've known Mirabai and Kabir, when you've known Tyagaraja and Annamacharya, how can you listen to this loud music? This is what the Harina is teaching us. Next is the Meena. Meena is the fish. As long as the fish doesn't see the worm in the bait, it is happy. When it gets caught, it dies. Man was given the mouth for two reasons. One to eat, one to speak. We speak what we should not and we eat what we should not. That is why we get caught. It is lovely to have, to observe silence in the world, says the Bhagavata. By the grace of the Lord and the inspiration of Lord of Swami Shivananji Maharaj, 41 days I observed silence except for the Katha. My dear listeners, Mauna is necessary. If Robin Sharma says observe 10 minutes silence every day, you say that's a bestseller who is saying it. All our rishis practice Mauna. Periva practice Mauna. For days together, they would go into silence. Silence is the time when you look inward, my listener. At the time you look inward. It's a disturbing experience, but a necessary experience. The treatment, which is necessary. Next comes Pingala. Pingala is a courtesan. She's a girl who calls people who are passing by for sensuous delight. One day she dresses up beautifully and stands at the doorstep. Nobody looks at her. Morning, afternoon, evening, night. Nobody looks at her. She's disappointed. Then she says, "It is desire that led me to disaster. If I had offered myself to the Lord, my life would have been so beautiful." This Pingala becomes a guru for us. She becomes a guru for us. Next comes Arbhaka. I'm sure you have a child at home. A grandchild is the best de-stressing formula at home. Whatever be your problem, when you come back from office and the child says, "Tata, Dada," you're very happy. One moment, your BP is normal. Why? Because the child is innocent. If you fight with a child today, within 10 minutes, it'll be friendly with you. But if you shout at someone, you'll say, "Amma, you scolded me in 2008, September 14th. You remember it. An adult memory never forgives. A child forgets and forgives. That's why retain the child in you. Retain the child who forgets and forgives. Next comes Kumari. Kumari is a young maiden who has guests at home. She makes them sit in the front room, goes into the kitchen, and she is pounding grain. When she's pounding grain, her bangles are jingling. One by one, she removes them. Even when there are two bangles, they're jingling. Finally, she removes all except one. When there is one bangle, it doesn't jingle. What does it mean? When you do meditation, sit alone. Ekaki yata chittatma nirashir aparigraha. The Gita says, sit alone for a moment. One moment. Then you're thinking of the Lord. For bhajan, we have to sit together. But for meditation, we have to sit alone.
The next one is Sharakrit. Focus. Focus is what is necessary today. Children are not focusing. Multiple distractions for students. They can't focus. That's why before the exam, they are so nervous. In the classroom, they have not concentrated. The blacksmith who is making an arrow comes to the tip of the arrow. And even if the king's procession is passing by, he doesn't greet the king because the tip of the arrow will get broken. That is how you have to concentrate. That is how you have to concentrate to have success in your profession, success in your life. There was a man sitting in Maharashtra, writing debit, credit in the ledger. He's an accountant, Munimji, in a zamindar's house. A huge serpent came and surrounded him. People said, oh, the Munimji is gone today. Hariyom, he's gone, he's gone. After a while, the serpent unwound itself and went away. They went rushing to the Munimji and said, sir, you were about to be killed. Oh, really? I didn't realize. You were concentrating on the ledger, sir. This man said, I was concentrating on debit credit. I didn't even see the serpent around me. If I had concentrated on Krishna Panduranga, where would I have gone? Where would I have gone? He is the one who became Eknathji Maharaj, the famous mystic of Maharashtra, who looked at the Lord and said, what dazzling beauty, my master, what dazzling beauty.